What's good? It's your girl, Chrissy Renee. Make sure you subscribe to my channel. I make videos every Wednesday and Saturday, so if you subscribe, you won't miss out on anything, right? Cool. So, you know, so much good stuff has been happening in my life that I should be grateful for, that I should be proud of myself and stuff like that, right? Okay. But when you are as cute as a button like me, you know, there has to be some bullshit that's just gonna come your way and you just gotta go with it, right? So, you know, it's a typical sunny day here on the West Coast, right? And as you guys know, I live in Mexico at the moment. So, they've been building all day. Y'all need to cut that shit out now. I'm trying to make a video. Okay. They got it. So, it's your typical sunny, beautiful day here on the West Coast, right? So your girl got up, took a shower, ate some breakfast, and, you know, got a cute outfit, right? Now, I was going to wait to do my makeup in the car because sometime crossing the border over to Mexico. So I was going to do my makeup in the car, right? Because sometimes crossing over to America from Mexico, the lines can be really crazy. Sometimes it's like a 45-minute max to like 20 minutes, or sometimes you just go straight through and you're in America, right? Coming to America every fucking day. Well, you know, so I'm doing my makeup in the car because it's kind of a long line this day. You know, it's like 30 minutes to wait, so that's the perfect time to do a makeup, right? I can get out the car. I'm already slaying, honey. My outfit's on point. I'm gonna be cute today, honey. Give it to these girls. Well, you know, once I get up to the guy at the little border patrol that to give my ID, my passports, and stuff like that to come over and prove that you are a citizen. The little drug dog walks by. You know, I'm not scared, honey. You know, I'm a weed smoker, but I'm not a weed dealer, honey. I'm gonna smoke the pot. So there's no pot in the car. So the guy tells the other guy to come over there, I guess because they're so confused why a girl from Georgia license plate on her car is over here on the West Coast. Like, people can get up and move whenever they want. I'm not content, okay? I don't settle in my life. I don't wanna be somewhere, bitch. I can get up and move. I have that right. So they always ask me this question. So, Georgia, how did you end up over here on the West Coast? I drove across the country and now I'm over the West Coast. What do you mean? Okay. So, they tell the little dog to come over. I'm sorry, y'all. My nose is running. Let me just get that so I don't have to keep doing this. So, they tell the little drug dog to come over and the dog's walking around my car. I guess he's finding some gold or whatever. Because I'm like, damn, it's a blunt in here. Please tell me where it is so I can go smoke it. Okay. So they open my driver door with the dog. Mind you, I am terrified of mutts. This is a big ass dog. I like cute puppies, you know, cute puppies, small, that don't jump on people. This is a big ass mutt. It's a Great Dane, big as fuck. I'm scared as hell. The dog jumps in my car and is on top of me. I'm freaking out. Oh my God, oh my God, I'm afraid of dogs. Get your dog, sirs. Get your dog. So the dog gets in the passenger seat, goes to the bag, and they said, oh, there's something in your car. There's something in your car. So I'm like, did some of my friends leave something in my car and now I'm about to get fucked up and go to jail over this bullshit for them? Trust me, I ain't gonna talk to them bitches again if this go down. That's what I'm thinking. The dog comes back into the passenger seat, sits there, and looks at me like, what's up, bitch? Where we going? I'm like, get your ass out of my car because I'm afraid of dogs. Y'all like this hat, by the way. You know, I want to still be positive in my videos. Yeah, I'm cute. Shut up, phone. So, you know. You done? Okay. So. So it was like two more officers were coming over there. These are American people, by the way. I already got an issue with the government. They think they can just tell us what to fuck to do. They did not create this universe. God did. Like, who are y'all to think it's okay to search my car and it's okay to ask all these damn questions that are irrelevant to you? You know, they always ask, what are you coming to America to do today? What do you mean? I'm coming over here to have fun and live my life. Like, I don't need to tell you day by day. One time, this homophobic, transphobic person was so rude to me. He said, where are you going, Chrissy? So what I said, I'm going to go fuck my boyfriend. And I don't have a boyfriend. But I told him that because he was being nosy as hell. The guy grabs my arm. Like, one of the officers grabbed my arm because he sees that I'm freaking about the dog. So they're not getting this damn dog out of my car. So I'm freaking out about this dog. And then I'm thinking, oh, he's going to save me to get away from this dog because I know there's nothing in my car. You know, I do sometimes smoke blunts in my car every now and then because I feel like it's my car. I paid for it. I pay my car insurance. I put the gas in this car. If it breaks down, I have to pay for it to get it fixed. No one else. So you're not going to tell me what to do. Okay. As long as the weed's not in my car, that's all I care about. So they grab my arm and he puts me in handcuffs. So I'm like, now, mind you, this is at the border. It's tons of people. Everybody's looking at me because I'm this tall black girl coming out of Mexico. So it's majority of the people are Hispanic. So they're like looking at me like, what's going on? Like, what's happening with her? You know, people got Snapchat, Twitter, Instagram, and Facebook nowadays. I don't want to be a fucking meme on the internet with me getting handcuffs when I'm an innocent ass girl. The only crime that I commit every day is being cute and snatching these bitches' edges every day. That's all I am, you know, I admit it, yes. Take me red-handed, you know, I'm red-handed on that department. But anyways, so they put me in handcuffs. I'm sitting here like, what are y'all doing? Like, why are you putting me in handcuffs? Our dog smells weed in your car. Like, I said, I know there may be the smell of weed because I pick up weed and I smoke weed. Like I said, but trust and believe, I didn't leave no crumbs in here because I smoked it all with my bitches. You feel me? So I was like, well, you could just be telling us that. I said, well, why would I put myself in a situation, have weed in the car, and get arrested like an idiot? Like, anybody who would do dumb shit deserve to go to jail. So, and it's not dumb to smoke weed. It's actually the thing now. But anyways, you know, I'll be having these bitches having press. I smoke a blunt. I'm fine. But I say, you guys wait till you're 18 to smoke if you're underage. I don't want to be a bad influence. They're sitting there, like, talking, whatever the hell they're talking about. So I'm like, grab my phone off the car. I need my phone so I can tell my mom what's going down if I need to call my parents. So they, you know, we'll bring it. I said, make sure you grab my purse. Don't drop my money because that's my money and I want my money. So you bitches try to take my money. I'm going to fucking not act a fool on y'all. So they walk me in front of all these people to this room. Shut up, phone. So they walk. I'm really irritated right now. You know what? Shut the hell up. So they walk me in front of everybody into this room. So I went inside of this room. I'm so handcuffed at this point. You know, I don't get in trouble. I try to make the best decisions ever, like I said, and mind my own business and just get by. Like, everybody else is trying to get by. Okay. So they take me to this room. They're saying, okay, we gotta search you, open your legs. And this is, it's a female that's doing it. And it's like 10 men in the room. So they're like, she's patting me up here, touching me. I'm saying, well, my boobs are very sore, so be very calm and gentle with me. So she's like, okay. So they get onto the below the waist part. And it's like, so are you a female? And I said, yes, I am. But one of the guys that was in the room actually is working at the border, so he knew that I was trans. So I guess he thought it was okay to ask, well, do you have a penis or a vagina? Like, what's up? And I'm sitting there looking like, why does that matter? And so the lady was like, well, because I can't touch you down there and pat you if you have a penis, it's against the law. I said, well, you shouldn't be fucking patting me anywhere. I feel like I'm being molested. Like, I feel like I'm being fucking raped. You feel me? So I answer their dumbass question, and then like this dude started like patting on me, and I'm just disgusted because he's not even cute. I wanted this other cute officer that was behind the desk to touch on me. But he didn't. You know, they do that and they're like, you know, asking me all these other questions, where I'm from, where I live, and what I do for work. And I was like, honey, that's irrelevant. Like, what do y'all need? Like, you need to search my car to find out there's nothing in it. So they tell me to go sit down. Tell me why the fuck I was in this holding room for 3 hours, right? My friends are texting my phone, they're calling my phone, asking where I'm at because I'm supposed to be meeting up with them to go to the beach. I'm getting irritated. So they finally come back 3 hours later, right? Me thinking I'm about to go to fucking jail, like was praying to all the gods, all the basics. I was really in there, really praying. Please do not be any nugs or any seeds or shit in my car that I didn't know about because then I'm going to jail and I have to take a mugshot. I'm really gonna be pissed. So they finally come back 3 hours later to tell me that, oh, you're good to go. So I said, so y'all just humiliated me in front of everybody at the border. Just put me in handcuffs to have me walk across the fucking parking lot in front of everybody, get searched in front of all the officers for nothing? Just because my car smelled like weed? honey, I don't know if it's just me, but I felt like that was the most embarrassing moment in my life to be handcuffed when you know you're innocent. And it's just like, so much was going through my mind, like the Black Lives Movement. Am I going to go to jail? Am I going to die in jail? What do they do to trans girls in jail? You know, like I said, I try to go by the law. I try to go by the rules. But, I am so embarrassed to even tell y'all this story. Like, I wasn't even going to tell you. I was just going to pretend like this never happened. Like, I haven't told my parents because they would really freak out. Like, you're already across the country. Now, shit's like that happening. We kind of want you to come back home. But I'm not going back home because I'm really, really happy over here. So that's how my day went. So now I'm going to ask you guys, what is probably the most embarrassing or humiliating moment of your lives that you want to share with me? And I'll be reading the comments and responding. I don't know. It just gets bullshit. Just always just comes my way every now and then. But when you're cute, what do you expect? Anyway, so I make videos every Wednesday and Saturday. So make sure you subscribe to my channel and follow me on all my social media accounts. My links are in my description. And I will see you guys next time. So keep it cute or get cut. Now, bye.